You know, at some level, it's terrific to be here today and talk about creating an opportunity for people here in the Commonwealth of Mass to do something great for a great cause, and that is to sign up to participate in the ALS ONE license plate drive and to raise money for research. But I would be remiss if I didn't start by saying that this issue has some personal history for the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And I remember when Polito was first diagnosed, and he made the decision to try and take what admittedly was a horrible personal tragedy and experience for him and try and turn it into something positive, and created the ALS Fund for Research out of UMass Medical under Dr. Brown's leadership. And clearly, UMass is considered among many great institutions to be one of the major players in ALS research in the United States. And you then add to that the work that was done by the Frades family and by Pete Frades and his family and all of those who came to the cause around ALS research associated with the Ice Bucket Challenge.
I'm going to start with a quote, because today I'd like to highlight three families that have done a tremendous amount of work to advance this cause. And the first is, I could go home and be secluded, curled up in a ball and cry and wait to die, or I could take the time that I have left and move the needle a little bit. I believe God gave this disease to me so that I can help find a treatment for this awful disease, and I will do all that I can to make that happen. And that is Kevin Gosling. And we want to thank Kevin and his family for understanding the need to move that needle and to move that ball forward. Certainly, and Kathy, their twin sons, Jake and Joey, and I believe another son, Scott, are doing all of that. But they recognized with their father that there was a lot of splintered silos when it comes to figuring out how to move that ball forward. And it was Kevin's dream to see this all come together, obviously strength in numbers, and this one being number one, to bring all of the organizations relative to research, organizations relative to care, to come together and work toward this common goal.
It's never a great day to be diagnosed with ALS. So I want to especially recognize the doctors, the clinicians, the compassionate care folks who are here today, because they have dedicated their lives to finding a treatment that will eliminate the suffering that those of us, the families that you've heard about, are battling in this horrific disease. The beast has become itself mortally wounded and is slowly, after 75 years, giving up its secrets because of these wonderful people, Dr. Brown, Dr. Landers, Dr. Sitkovich, here in Massachusetts.